Hi there, this is Ankit, back again with another video. So first of all, welcome all of you in my channel KN Technology. So without wasting our time, let's start our today's video. So in this video, we will develop a new page called buzzhire.html and CSS file that are associated with it. As I told you earlier in last video that we will discuss the next page in next video. So in this video we will develop a buzzhire page. Okay, so first let me show you about something our buzzhire page so that you can get some idea about that. Okay, so in this video we will discuss only about the navigation bar. Okay, as you can see this navigation bar, so let us start coming to the Sublime text editor. Editing a new page. Called buzzhire.html. That's it. And new CSS file for buzzhire page. That's it. Now since we have created our both of the pages, and so we are moving to the buzzhire page. To do some coding part. First of all, let me copy the CDN link of Bootstrap and jQuery from the last. Sorry, from the page of Buzzbook that you have developed earlier. Okay, I am copying from bus ticket page. That's it. Now opening of nav tag, inside nav tag there will be attribute for class having the value nav bar inverse dg danger and a sticky top, sorry, fixed top. Inside nav tag there will be a div tag with the class attribute having the value navbarBrand. Inside this div tag there will be button tag with the type attribute having the value button and a class attribute having the value navbarToggler and data target will be hashtag buzzhire navbar and data toggle will be collapse. Okay, inside button tag there will be a span tag with the class attribute having the value navbar toggler icon. Okay, after closing a button tab, there will be outside of dive tab, there will be another dive tab with the class attribute having the value collapse. Yeah, bar collapse and ID will be that one that we have created, that we have provided in the data target attribute. Inside this dive tab, there will be UL tab with the class attribute, the class attribute having the value nav bar nav. Inside this UL tag, there will be li tag with the class attribute nav item. Inside this, there will be anchor tag with the class attribute, okay, and the value will be nav link. Okay, and here the content will be, let me first check what was the content here. Content will be bus ticket. Okay, and like this li tag, there will be another li tag and it could be 3 times as per our requirement, and the content per second li tag will be rpool, and the third content will be what is the third content, bus hire. Okay, that's it for this UL tag. Now there will be another UL tag, and inside this UL tag there will be another class called ML Auto. Now save it and first see the changes. Inside tutorial folder, bus hire page, as you can see, navbar is visible but the content of navbar is not visible, and item is also not showing by clicking on the navigation bar button. So there must be some error in the code. So let's check it. Navbar it will be ERS inverse, BG danger, free stop, navbar to the bus and then drag to collapse. Okay, spelling here, aspect to last number to break. Okay, let me check first. Still the button is not working, and also the okay, I have left one class, that is number expand small. Now you can see coming, and also but still the button is not working. So to make the button working properly, we need to check the classes of buttons more precisely. Collapse, navbar collapse, and bus hire navbar, both are right, but why it is not working? Button type button, navbar toolbar, data target bus hire navbar, data toggle collapse, Nerma toggler icon is right. It should work. Okay. No, still not working. Why is it so? Let me check. Nav class number never spend small busy ginger fish stop class name for brand button type button class name bar tooler data target bus higher number data tooler collapse. All are correct code. Collapse number, collapse bus number name. Okay, dive class. Okay, here is the problem. There should be no hashtag inside ID attribute of dive class of dive tag in I023. Okay, now it is working. Okay, change the screen size, click on button. As you can see, working properly. And one more event is that we should make that button visible. For this, let's provide a border as we have did in the last videos of bus ticket page and main page navigation bar. Okay, so border space border 4. Actually, this is not a efficient work. This is called we can call it a way to make the button visible anyway, but not in a proper way. Okay. Okay, and okay. One more thing, we need to provide text light and font weight bold. Okay, that's it. Refresh the page and you can see. Good, good, good. One more thing. Okay, not a problem. Okay, that's it for today's video. We will develop the next section of bus hire page in next video. Okay. That's enough. And one more thing, please like, subscribe and share my channel and do hit the bell icon for the latest videos. And thank you. See you in next video.